So hi, I'm Maxime Coquelin. I work at Red Hat in the virtualization and networking team. And today we talk about PostCopy live migration with VHost user backend. So the the reason we added PostCopy live migration to VHost user backend is that today we can only use pre-copy live migration, which is a normal way to do live migration. And this method can cause some issues when we have high pages write rates. And so NFV is a case where we have a high rate of pages writing. So when it happens, either the migration time is really important, is too big, and even sometimes it can never happen, or the downtime could be also important. And with PostCopy live migration, the goal is to have a deterministic migration time. So until recently, we didn't add support for VHost server backend, so you could only do PostCopy live migration with a classic VM, which is a virtual device. So first, we'll see what is pre-copy live migration to understand why there is some issues with it. So the concept of pre-copy live migration is to copy the guest memory from source to destination before the execution is started on the destination. And while this copy is done, as I said, it is still executing on source. Since it's still executing on the source side, some pages are still written by the guest or other processes into the guest memory. So we need to track this write. And this dirty paging logging must be done for writes done by the guest, write done by the QEMU process, and other process write like the VHost user backend running in OVS DPDK, for example. And in QEMU, we have a migration thread that is in charge of copying all the memory from source to destination. And this thread is in charge of gathering all the dirty pages information and send them to the destination host. And still, since the pages can be dirty while they are being copied to the destination, we need to the same page can be transferred multiple times, which cause longer migration time. And in some cases, it can even never converge if the guest is writing memory too fast, or if the throughput or if the bandwidth is too low. And in that case, so to overcome this, so we have either to slow down the guest, which will have an impact on performance, or to pause it, and it will have an impact on the downtime. So, as I said, we have to do dirty pages tracking at multiple levels. For the guest page write, this is done at KVM level. So the idea is that QEMU notify KVM that it needs to track dirty pages. So it does this with a dedicated IO control, with a dedicated flag. And KVM, when handling this request, creates a bitmap for each memory slot. And for each memory slot, it will remove the page write the write access to the memory pages. So when done, the dirty paging logging pages logging start. So when the guest writes a page, it will cause an EPT violation because we have removed the access, the write access, and so we have a VM exit. So we jump into KVM, and KVM will set the corresponding bit into the dirty looking page, the bitmap. And once that's done, it will restore the write access to the page, so that for further write onto this page, it will not trap anymore. And on QU side, we have the migration thread that collects this dirty bitmap with an IO control, and it will transfer it to the destination. It will transfer the pages to the destination. So this is nice because we don't have to modify the guest OS to handle the migration. But each time we have the guest writing a page, we have a VM exit. And so it means that we switch from level 1 to level 0, and the vCPU is no more executing. So we have a performance impact. And since the same page can be transferred multiple times, we have an impact on migration time. And we have a feature that do CPU throttling to decrease the vCPU speed in some way if the dirty page is too high, but doing this will also have a performance impact. In the BIOS user backend, we have a similar way to we also do dirty page logging because we have an external process to QMU that will write the guest memory, so we need to track this. And so we have a VS user protocol extension to do that, so that QMU allocates the bitmaps and shares them with the VS user backend using a dedicated setlog based request. And then for each page written, the backend will set the bits in the bitmap. And periodically, QMU will check the dirty bits, transfer the pages, and clear the bits in the bitmap. And so that we need to do that some atomic operation, because we could lose some dirty pages if we didn't do that. And when you have multiple queues plus QMU doing this atomic operation in the same memory region, it creates a contention, which will also cause some performance issue. So to overcome this, we implemented an optimization, which in the VS user backend consists in having a pair VIRT queue cache. So as long as we don't commit, we don't write back the descriptor to the guest, we don't mark the pages as dirty. And so we have less contention doing that, but still that's not perfect. We can still have a lot. If we have a lot of queue, we can have a lot of contention and fail on converging. And the auto converge feature that is used by QMU for the guest that reduce CPU throttling might not help in this case, because it's another process, so we don't the backend can still write even if the guest is slowed down. So we looked at post-copy-like migration for the source backend to overcome this. So the difference with pre-copy is that with post-copy, we start the execution on the destination before all the memory has been copied. So we start by copying only the minimal VM states, so like the CPU states, the registers, the devices states, and which is a few kilobytes, not megabytes, and would start execution on the destination with that. And we, in parallel, we start to copy pages from source to destination. And at some point, the guest will try to access a page that is not copied, that is not copied yet. So what will happen is that a page fault. So we have to handle a page fault, and we use some mechanism to request this specific missing page to be able to continue execution. So this page fault handling is done by user fault FD, so that we don't have the kernel to request QEMU on source side to do some network communication to get the missing page. So the advantage with this solution is that we have no more convergence issue because the page will be copied only once. But if the migration fails for some reason, for example, we lose the network, we cannot recover the migration because we have part of the state of the VM state in the destination and part in the source. So in this case, we are lost. So as I said, to implement this, we use user fault FD. So user fault FD provides a dedicated syscall to be able to send some I/O controls to. So first I/O control is to negotiate the API because depending on the kernel version, we can have different operations available. We have a register I/O control that we use for registering to user fault FD every memory slot of the guest. Then when we want to map a received page into the guest, we have a copy I/O control. If the page is empty, is on zeros, we also have an I/O control to do that, so that avoid to mem set some memory. And when we are done with copying or setting the new page, we wake up the thread that was in the page fault using the wake I/O control. So like with free copy, we have a dedicated thread running to handle these page faults. And so we just have to receive the missing page's information to pull and read the user fault FD. And what's great with user fault FD is that you have also a non-cooperative mode, so it's interesting for our use case. Which means that we can have an external process that can handle the page fault of another process. So let's see how PostCopy works in detail. So vCPU is started on destination, start to execute. At some point, it tries to access a missing page. So we trap into the hypervisor. And the hypervisor will notify the migration thread with through a poll-in, and so the migration thread can read the missing page address and request to the destination to the source the corresponding page. And after this, it will when the page is received, it will copy it into guest memory and resume execution of the vCPU. So what we did was to add support for VS user backend with PostCopy, so that when the VS user backend, that can be, for example, OVSDPDK, try to access a page that is missing, so that QEMU can request the page to the source and continue execution. So to do this, we use the non-cooperative mode I discussed earlier so that it is QEMU that requests the missing page because it knows about the QEMU source. And to do this, the host user backend gets the user fault FD and share it with QEMU. And for every region, it maps of the every memory guest memory region. It maps. It will register them to user fault FD. And doing that, we are done. Except that when QEMU will receive the missing page information, it will receive an address into the process virtual address space, and not in the backend process address space. So it needs a way to translate this address into its address space. And for this, we need to send the QEMU the memory region of the guest that the backend mapped to QEMU. And to do that, we have extended the VHOST user protocol to be able to send the user fault FD to via the Unix socket. Notify the slave, so the SDPDK, that we have to start post copy, and notify it when post copy is done. Also, to send the slave address space information, we have extended the set memory table protocol request. So I did some benchmark. So it's not realistic benchmark because the benchmark consists in doing migration on the same host, so we have an unlimited bandwidth, and the workload also is not really realistic. So we are using DPDK both in the host and in the guest. It is doing an I/O loopback, so it is doing I/O forwarding. We inject packets and it is doing an I/O loop. And after that, we start the migration. So when we use a guest of 3 gig of RAM with 1 gig huge pages, so we have a forwarding rate of 10 million packets per second, we see that we have a big gain in the total migration time, because it goes from 16 to 2 seconds with post copy, and a slightly better, but it's not really noticeable, downtime with post copy also. Then I switch to use 2 meg huge pages, and we see that with pre copy we have a higher migration time. Whereas with post copy, we remain at the same duration. So that confirms why post copy is good for this. But we can see that we have a higher downtime when using post copy. That might be explained because we have much more requests to with 2 meg pages to the destination to get the pages, and so it has some overhead at some point. So we have some remaining work to do. First, we have an issue with post copy that migration will break when the process pre-faults the shared memory. So, for example, if it use if the application of SDPDK call mlock all future with future parameter, the migration will fail because it will pre-fault the page before post copy is at mmap time before the migration is initiated. And we have no way today to prevent this. And the problem is that the guest user is the library, so we don't have control over the application. So maybe we need to have something like a new mmap flag to say never prefault or something like that. And at least we need to detect, be able to detect before doing the mmap that that the application has done an mlock, and so we could forbid post copy in that case. We still have also to enable post copy in OVS-DPDK, so it is supported in DPDK but not in OVS-DPDK yet. And we would also need to, of course, to run some benchmark in more realistic conditions with NFV workloads so that we can measure the packet drops, what is important, and also the migration time. So post-copy support has been released in DPDK 18.11. And for the VS user extension in QEMU, it has been added in 3.1. I'm working with QE team to have a more realistic benchmark. So I will try to post the result in a blog. And I would like to give some credit to David Gilbert, who work on the QEMU side of the post-copy support for VS user backend and post-copy in general, and Andrea Arcangeli, who added user full BFD support in the kernel. Thanks. So we need to do more. The question is: do we have some idea how to improve the downtime? So if we go to, I think you talk about downtime here. So first, we need to be sure what is the root cause of this downtime. So we need to try to trace and understand what is the exact reason of this. So we have maybe some idea, but we need to do the investigation before. So maybe we will have to, we could use an hybrid solution, would be to do pre-copy for one pass. So copy most of the guest memory to the destination, and after that do post-copy. For example, there is an option for that in Virsh, to pre-copy after, post-copy after pre-copy, to do that. So we need to see, depending on the use case, if we need the migration to finish early or not, if which tuning we need to do.
Or maybe speculate on the pages and bring them in advance.
There is already this kind of algorithm in QEMU, so that when it will fault on the page, when we'll have to handle a page fault, it will try then to send the pages around to speculate. So, if we don't have network outage, or it would be a bug that the post copy fail. But if it happens, it's really bad because we cannot recover. Okay, thank you.
I'm sorry, we are out of time.
But we can talk.